Dr. Khan, Dr. Yancy, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for having us.
Happy to be here.
We still understand that heart disease is the number one disease in America, number one killer in America, but COVID-19 is not making it any easier. Are heart patients more liable to suffer complications with COVID-19?
That's a great question. We know that in the last few months, COVID-19 has eclipsed heart disease as being the leading killer of Americans. And it's really important that individuals who have pre-existing heart disease, have high blood pressure, have heart failure when they've had a heart attack, are especially protected because they're at most at risk for having severe infection with the virus and then ending up in the hospital or even dying.
Now, are some heart diseases more liable for complications than others? For instance, is AFib more liable than angina or something like that?
So, really important question. And it turns out that heart failure, hypertension alone, obesity, advanced age are the things that have been well described. But atrial fibrillation is a not infrequent complication of COVID-19 infection. And those that have coronary disease are uniquely at risk, either because of vulnerability, that is, they may actually have another heart attack, or because they will end up having consequences just from working so hard to overcome the pneumonia. So two different things here. Those that are susceptible do include people with previous heart disease, including heart attacks. But in particular, the susceptibility is to either another traditional heart attack or the kind of heart injury that just comes from overwork because it is so hard to overcome the burden of this really complex pneumonia that happens in COVID-19.
If you want to talk about ironies, people, they're stressing us out about COVID-19, which is not helping people with heart conditions as well.
You know, that's correct. You think about what's going on right now. We're anxious about COVID-19. This is Heart Month. We're reminding ourselves that we still have the risk of heart disease. It's not gone away. And then it's wintertime, and there you are in Pittsburgh, and people are shoveling snow. I'm a little concerned because this could be a time when we will see a lot of people that will become a lot more ill.
Now, if you have contracted COVID-19 and you are suffering from heart ailment, heart disease, as we get over the virus, what should we be looking for as a heart patient?
That's a really important question because we know while most people are recovering from COVID-19, without any long-standing symptoms, many are experiencing long-term symptoms like fatigue or brain fog, some of which has been referred to as long COVID or long haul. But especially among heart patients, we know that there's the risk for the virus to attack the heart directly or cause heart damage because of the storm that's happening within the body. So looking out for signs of chest pain, discomfort, heart racing, or anything out of the ordinary is important.
And I'll add to that.
Go ahead.
I'll add to that. If anyone's having shortness of breath, that is not a benign issue because it either means there's residual lung injury from COVID-19 or it is the first sign that we need to take a deeper look at heart function and see what else is going on. But that's a tip-off for the average person. If you're experiencing shortness of breath and you know you recently had COVID-19, don't try to ride that out. That's an important observation.
Before we go any further, is there a website we can go to for information about heart disease and COVID-19 and what we should be doing about it?
Great question. As American Heart Month, there is great information on the American Heart Association website, as well as on our website at Northwestern Medicine at nm.org.
Now let's move over to the vaccine because luckily now we are seeing the vaccine distributed, but there's a lot of people who have questions about the vaccine, and if you are suffering from heart disease, should we be worried about getting the vaccine or have any concerns?
No, we should be moving to the front of the line if we have heart disease because it's just that important. I know there are a lot of questions about the vaccine, but very quickly I can tell you, one, they work incredibly well. Two, they're safe. Three, they've been tested in multiple people within the community. So whether you're old, young, black, white, we know with certainty that the vaccines work. And the next thing we know is that maybe not as well, but they actually work good enough even against the variants. The one statement that all of us in science are able to say about the vaccines, and there are now five, we can tell you this, they're pretty good. They actually work.
So in other words, do not fear going to get the vaccine, and as a matter of fact, do it as quickly as you can.
Correct. I mean, it will be important for everyone to make their own decision. I want to be clear about that. But based on the science, it is overwhelmingly the right thing to do, particularly when you compare it to the risk of having COVID-19. I mean, hands down, the vaccine is the better approach.
As heart disease patients, should we also be concerned with maintaining the social distancing, the masking, the CDC guidelines, more than average people?
That's a great question. We should all be vigilant about those guidelines, wearing a mask, physical distancing, and hand washing. But as we noted, patients who have heart disease are more likely to have severe COVID, and therefore we want to be extra careful in those individuals.
Another thing we're hearing about is that the trips to the emergency room, trips to the doctor, trips to the cardiologist are down because people are afraid of COVID-19. They're afraid of the spread of the disease. If I'm feeling chest pains, other symptoms, basically don't be scared to go to the ER. Don't be scared to go to the doctor.
So important. We're all feeling this anxiety, this concern that we may get exposed going to the doctor, the hospital, but it's really important not to delay seeking care if there's a potential heart attack or stroke, or even if you're not sure what could be happening, to get care so that we don't seek the consequences of that. We know that the hospital is very safe. We've got great protocols in place to take care of individuals safely.
And anybody that's been to an ER lately knows that they are being super cautious about preventing the spread of the disease.
It might even be safer than most grocery stores.
It better be.
I was going to say, some of the people I've seen at the grocery stores.
Yeah.
I think I'll just add one more thing. As it is Heart Health Month, one of the things that we are especially focusing on are women and heart disease. We know that cardiovascular disease or heart disease is the number one killer of women, and especially focusing on the fact that symptoms may be different in women, and women may be less likely to seek care or receive care for heart disease. We want to raise awareness that this is the number one killer for women in the U.S.
Again, where can we go for information about heart disease and COVID-19 and what our options are?
We've got some great information from the Centers for Disease Control online, the CDC website, your public health department, as well as our website at Northwestern Medicine, which you can access at nm.org.
Now, with that, this is great information, and I appreciate you taking the time to help get this information out. And Dr. Khan, Dr. Yancy, thank you for joining us today.
Well, thank you.